Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in the last video, which I literally just filmed, but you would have seen a few days ago, I talked about what a cleft is, because there's lots of people who might not know, or they might be a bit confused as to exactly what it is about. You know, it might be a bit hazy in their mind, so I hope that video cleared some things up for people. But today I'm going to be talking about terminology and, you know, using the correct terms or terms that people with a cleft might be less sensitive to and things like that. I have touched upon this in a video before. It was my Wendy Williams video, which I did in January, talking about how Wendy Williams publicly offended a lot of people with clefts. If you want to see that video, I'll link it down below. Also, if you want to see the previous video, I'll link that down below, and they'll both be up here as well. So first I'm going to talk about a few terms, and then I'm going to go into a few things that I was talking about with some fellow clefties. That is the term of endearment that we use for ourselves. Yeah, I think it's really cute. So first I'm going to go through the terms that might be a bit more derogatory. What is happening out there? I have my window open and I think there's some young people playing outside, so you might hear them scream in the background, but ignore that. I don't know if it's picking up on the camera or not. So yes, where were we? We're gonna go through some negative terms first of all, or terms that might be more sensitive. Does that make sense? That might be more offensive, that's the word. Or people with a cleft might feel a little bit upset with people using, or it might unsettle them. The big one that I used to use because I didn't think about it, it is used medically. They do use it all around the world to describe cleft or craniofacial conditions, but I don't like it anymore. So I got together through Operation Smile, which is my favorite charity, such a good charity. You know, shout out to them because they are amazing and I love them and I miss going on missions with them, and I really want to go on a mission with them when all this is over, all the crisis, everything. But anyway, hello to everyone at Operation Smile in case you're watching this. Yeah, so we got together, a group of us, the 2 years that I did it in San Diego and in Italy. They started bringing clefties together so we could talk, and the second year that they did that was in Italy. And we actually did a panel where we spoke in front of hundreds of students about our experiences. We answered some questions. It was actually quite an amazing, exhilarating experience. It was very moving and very, like, we were all crying because some things were brought up that just made us all tear. It was very, emotional? Is that the word I'm looking for? It was a very, it was an amazing thing. But we met up, we chatted a bit, and we talked about terminology that might be more derogatory and how we would like maybe Operation Smile or other you know, people to stop using, because us those of us affected by the condition, we just, you know, we felt that they were not very nice terms. They were kind of harsh, and someone brought up this term that I'd used before, and I was like, do you know what, that makes sense. It's actually not that nice a term. Well, the term I'm talking about is facial deformity, and it basically implies that you're deformed, that there's something, kind of feels like someone's saying there's something wrong with you, even though it's been used for so long, that term, and, you know, professionals use it. It's a derogatory term that many of us don't really like being called. I don't know. That's basically the gist of it, but that is one of the terms. Another term is, and I was talking to some of my cleft friends in a Snapchat group that we have, and I was asking them for some input for this video, and that is hair lip. Hair lip is used a lot, and we don't like it. My mom has always said she hated that term. They say it in French as well. My mom's Belgian, if you didn't know. Yeah, hair lip is quite offensive, actually. One of my friends, I'm on Snapchat. I'm gonna go get what she said. Where is it? Yeah, she says, I really hate it when people call it a hair lip. I don't know about you guys, but I just prefer it when people call it a cleft lip. Yeah, it's just a very, I don't know. And if you're a clefty out there and you don't mind the term, that's fine too. But that's another term that maybe those of you who are, if you ever talk about a cleft, and you're just wondering how to go about talking about a cleft, maybe don't use that term. Another one that actually I hadn't heard until my friend brought it up, and my friend told me that this was used for something that was quite official, and they called it facially impaired. And when I heard that, I was like, what? No. Okay, so that's not a thing, first of all. Second of all, no. Because it was talking about, it was kind of referring to someone who's repaired, cleft is repaired, is facially impaired. That is, that no, I'm not facially impaired. I can talk, I can use my face the way most people do. I don't even see how that works. But anyway, yeah, that's another one. I think that's it. One good thing is that there are more positive terms than there are negative terms to use, which is great. So why don't we just use all the positive ones anyway? Oh, before I jump into positive ones, there's one that I'm not totally set on. If they use it, I'm like, you know what, it's all right. It's still a bit derogatory, but it's not as bad as facial deformity. And it's used a lot to describe a cleft in a capacity that's medical or professional, and that is birth defect. I mean, it's used to describe more than just a cleft, but I'm kind of like this about it. I'm not sure how I feel about it. I'm not totally annoyed by it, but I'd rather you don't say you have a birth defect to my face, or talk about me in that way, or any other fellow clefty. I'm on the fence about that one. Now for the positive ones, which is what you guys hopefully have been waiting for, to learn what to say about a cleft. Cleft condition, that is a positive term. It is easy to say. It describes exactly what it is. It's a condition. It's not a defect, it's not a deformity, it's a condition. It's just so much kinder to use that. It's not a complicated phrase. So if you want to talk about someone with a cleft, you're not sure if they have a lip or a palate, or what exactly it is. If you want to know more about that, about lips and palates, check out my last video. If you're not sure what to call it a cleft condition. And if you really want to be specific and you're not sure if it's a cleft condition or something like Treacher-Collins syndrome, you know, something a bit slightly different to a cleft, then call it a craniofacial condition. That's a bit of a long-winded phrase, but if you're really not sure, maybe use that. But cleft condition is fine. Another thing that one of my friends has said is facial difference. Facial difference is, you know, I find it's not offensive in any way. Sure, I have a difference. Everyone's different. Technically, everyone has a facial difference. But a facial difference is another more gentle term to describe it. And then last but not least, cleft lip and palate. You know, when all else fails, cleft lip and palate. Even if they don't have a palate or a lip, it's kind of, well, you can use cleft condition in that sense when you're really not sure. What I don't like is when people, this is kind of goes, not the negative terms, but it's kind of like what not to say. A lot of people actually call a cleft lip and palate a cleft palate. When I have the, they actually, when they see someone with the lip, they call it a cleft palate, when that's clearly not the palate, that's the lip. And I know, again, it's just not knowing much about it, but like I said, if in doubt, use cleft condition. So going through some of my friends in that group, one of them says, not sure if this counts, but I don't like when I tell someone about it and my experience, and they say that it's obvious that I have one and they already know. So yeah, I don't think I've had this that much. My scars, it's apparently not that noticeable. I obviously see it every day in the mirror, but a lot of people, when I tell them, they're like, oh, I didn't even notice. But here, she has had the experience that people say, yeah, it's obvious, I knew. And that can be quite annoying. She thinks that people should say, thank you for telling me, or something like that, just a little bit more. Like, people are very forward, and it can come off a little bit rude how they phrase it, you know, sometimes. Someone else, oh my gosh, please bring up okay, cool as a response when you tell people you have a cleft. So I don't know if I've had this personally, but a lot of them said when we met up that people would say, oh, okay, cool, as a response. And our group is called okay, cool on Snapchat and on WhatsApp. One unintentionally rude thing I've heard is, when did you break your nose? That teachers asked me when talking about times they broke bones as kids. Yeah, so I'm not sure if I've had this. I may have when I was a kid, but I don't remember. People think that maybe you've broken your nose. Nope. I was born this way. I had a surgery. Yeah, that's what happened. Thank you to those of you in our little OK Cool group who responded and gave me some things that they don't really like when people say, or, you know, who told me little stories like that. That's all for today. If you want to see more cleft content, I do have a playlist where I call it Cleft Corner, and anything about clefts I put in there. I also have a playlist that's about Operation Smile, which is the charity I mentioned. I hope you're all keeping well and safe. Happy Cleft Awareness Week, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!